Hey, it's Streakz, and welcome back to the channel, man. As you guys and girls know, we are 7 days away from COD World War II dropping. So I had to do a video on basic tips to increase your KD in World War II. This also refers to any Call of Duty that was boots on the ground and somewhat jetpacking. And yes, I'm so excited to drop that term from my vocabulary, man. So let's go ahead and start with tip number one. When it comes to a new Call of Duty, there comes new maps and new game modes. So obviously, unless you had some inside connect and got the game early, you're not gonna know these maps very well. Unless you're just like a beast like the Mark of J or Elite Shot, you're not gonna wanna run straight to the center and try to destroy everyone in sight. I'm just saying. And what I mean by this is take your time and learn before you explore. In every Call of Duty, I've always tried to stick to the outsides of the maps versus the centers until I learn the map, you know what I'm saying? Now, once you know the map, it's a different story. You can go balls to the wall if you wanna. To improve your KD at first, man, you're gonna wanna learn the maps before you just run to the center. Now, number two, the biggest thing that people know but never seem to do is aim and down sight around every corner or building that you enter. It's the easiest way to win gunfights, man. I mean, it just is. In Call of Duty, in most shooter games in general, whoever gets the first shot wins. Now, I'm not saying you always ADS, like when you spawn straight out of spawn, don't ADS, man, that looks goofy. But if you're in a high traffic area and you know it, make sure you ADS and get your shot before they do. It wins like 80% of the time, man. Number three, let's jump back to new game modes. I know it's very tempting to see what's fresh, and you always should, but that's where a lot of your KD tends to get destroyed. I've done it a million times, especially when Kill Confirmed came out. I played that game mode and I sucked, but I seen the score you got from it and I kept on playing it, but I was smacking the you know what out of my KD. Now, I did end up getting good at it and enjoyed it, but it took a while. I mean, I knocked at least a 0.7 off the KD, baby. So stick to game modes that you know and that you enjoy and that you're good at. And if you're like me and don't really care about KD anymore, grab a RPG and try to troll somebody. You know what I'm saying? Now, number four, and this has to be, I repeat, man, has to be the main reason I raise my KD in Call of Duty. And that is to bump fire your weapon. And if you don't know what I mean about this, comment below, man, and let me know and I'll make a video on that. But I seriously raise my KD from like a 1.6 to about a 2.8 to a 3.5 in every Call of Duty since I've learned to bump fire. Not in BO3 or Infinite Warfare, because I'm not the greatest at them boost jumping games. But it's all about accuracy in Call of Duty, and whoever is more accurate wins every time. So if you're at a long distance or even a medium distance, do not, once again, do not just pull and hold the trigger button down. If it's a long distance, give it a few baby bumps until you get the kill, you know, just barely tap the trigger. Now that's at a long distance. But if you're at a medium distance, hold it just a little bit longer and let it go. Let four or five bullets go out of the chamber and then let it go. It will like 100% improve your KD, bro. I mean, that's like a guarantee. So that pretty much sums up the video. This is the top four reasons, or should I say top four ways to improve your KD when the game drops. I'll definitely bring more videos like this, you know what I'm saying, once I learn the game and all that. So if you guys enjoyed this video or learned anything, make sure you like and subscribe, please. It really helps the channel. Thanks for tuning in, man. Streakz, I'm out of here. Appreciate y'all watching.